SpaceX's new last-minute booster 12 catching plan. It's not what you might think. It's a crucial fix. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Hey everyone, welcome back. Right now, we're just T-minus 4 hours from launch, and honestly, I was planning to get some sleep, but the excitement got the best of me. So instead, I decided to make this video for you all. I've seen a lot of questions in our community about the Super Heavy booster catching plan, and many of you have been asking for an update dedicated to just that. So here it is. Let's dive into it. You know, after a long period of preparation, the upcoming Flight 5 is not just about launching, but also about introducing the revolutionary booster catch mechanism, a goal that has been eagerly anticipated by both SpaceX and the entire space community. Since the introduction of Starship, SpaceX has been working to make it fully reusable, aiming to bring down launch costs and increase the frequency of space missions. While the Falcon 9 booster is partially reusable, returning to land or landing on droneships in the ocean, Super Heavy and Starship are designed to be fully reusable. The introduction of the Mechazilla system, giant chopstick arms attached to the launch tower, represents a significant leap toward this goal. These arms are designed to catch the massive Super Heavy booster as it returns to the launch site. The catching mechanism was added to the Flight 5 timeline, marking a significant shift from the previous four flights, where the Super Heavy booster either soft landed in the ocean or was not recovered. SpaceX has meticulously planned for this moment, conducting numerous tests and upgrades to the Starbase launch site and the Super Heavy booster itself. In recent weeks, there has been a flurry of activity at Starbase as the team gears up for this historic flight. Integration tests and chopstick tests have been continuously conducted, and SpaceX has shared positive updates from these tests, including integration trials and the successful operation of the water deluge system to mitigate heat and pressure at launch. However, the biggest hurdle was the approval from the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA. Now even FAA has approved the flight, and now Flight 5 is just hours away from its maiden launch. According to the latest updates, Flight 5 will feature several key steps towards Super Heavy's reusability. One major new addition is the Super Heavy landing burn shutdown and catch attempt at approximately 6 minutes and 56 seconds after liftoff, earlier than many analysts expected. This will occur just over 4 minutes after stage separation, much faster than previous predictions of up to 10 minutes for a splashdown landing. The return to the launch site will occur quicker than the ocean landings due to the reduced need for extensive navigation and deceleration operations. Upon approaching the launch tower, the Super Heavy booster will be guided to the center of the chopsticks. Its engines will shut down and the booster will be caught. After stabilization, the chopsticks will rotate and place the booster back onto the launch mount, a process that will be a breakthrough in rocket reusability if successful. This would put SpaceX one step closer to making Starship fully reusable and achieving a similar launch cadence to Falcon 9. While the timeline for Flight 5 is ambitious, it is dependent on multiple factors. SpaceX has emphasized that thousands of vehicle and pad criteria must be met for a catch attempt. If any of these criteria are not satisfied, Super Heavy will default to a splashdown in the Gulf of Mexico. This decision will ultimately be up to the mission's flight director and the booster's automated health checks. Safety remains the top priority for both the public and the SpaceX team. Both Super Heavy and Starship have undergone significant upgrades in preparation for Flight 5. These enhancements have been the result of years of research and months of testing, involving tens of thousands of hours of work by SpaceX engineers and technicians. For Super Heavy, these upgrades have been somewhat secretive, hidden behind the doors of the Mega Bay at Starbase. However, it has been confirmed that both the hardware and software have been optimized for the booster catch. The catch tower infrastructure has also been reinforced, with Mechazilla's chopsticks tested multiple times to ensure smooth operation during the catch process. Meanwhile, Starship itself has also seen substantial improvements. Over 12,000 hours were spent replacing the older generation of thermal protection system, TPS tiles, with new ones, alongside additional protective layers between the flaps and the structural elements of the ship. These upgrades are expected to improve Starship's re-entry capabilities and ensure a smoother landing, addressing issues encountered during Flight 4, where the landing was nearly successful but still fell short of perfection. If everything proceeds according to plan, Flight 5 will be a defining moment for the Starship program. The mission timeline begins with the propellant loading process, which starts 1 hour and 15 minutes before launch. During this phase, liquid methane and liquid oxygen will be loaded onto both Starship and Super Heavy, a process that will take approximately 47 minutes. At T-minus 30 seconds, the SpaceX flight director will verify the go-ahead for launch. This will be followed by the activation of the water deluge system just 10 seconds before liftoff to help reduce heat and pressure during launch. The Raptor engines will ignite in sequence 3 seconds before launch, and then Flight 5 will begin. After liftoff, the Super Heavy booster will perform as expected, reaching max Q, maximum aerodynamic pressure, approximately 1 minute after launch. At T plus 2 minutes and 33 seconds, the booster's main engines will cut off, followed by stage separation. Starship will then activate its engines and continue toward orbital velocity, while Super Heavy initiates its boost back burn to return to the launch site. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. Once the boost back burn is complete, Super Heavy will enter the supersonic state and activate its landing burn at T plus 6 minutes and 8 seconds. The next few moments will be crucial as the booster approaches the Mechazilla chopsticks for a catch attempt. If successful, this will mark a major milestone for SpaceX and the Starship program. As for Starship, it will continue its journey into orbit. Around T plus 8 minutes, the engines will cut off, and Starship will likely complete one orbit of Earth before beginning its re-entry process. SpaceX has not added an in-space engine ignition step to this flight, so the focus will be on ensuring a smooth re-entry and landing. The Starship landing is expected to take place in the Indian Ocean, where it will splash down at around T plus 1 hour and 5 minutes. This will mark the conclusion of Flight 5, assuming all steps are successfully completed. While the focus of Flight 5 is on SpaceX's ambitious goal of catching the Super Heavy booster, the mission also carries significant implications for the broader space exploration community. NASA is closely watching SpaceX's progress, particularly with regard to the Artemis program and the development of the Human Landing System, HLS, for future lunar missions. At a recent meeting, NASA's Acting Deputy Associate Administrator emphasized the importance of Starship success for Artemis 3, which aims to return humans to the moon. Flight 5 will be crucial in demonstrating Starship's reusability and its ability to reach orbit and land safely. These achievements will lay the groundwork for future tests of the HLS system, which NASA hopes to see operational by 2026. In addition to the Super Heavy catch, Flight 5 will be a stepping stone toward achieving the rapid launch cadence that SpaceX envisions. By mastering the processes of reaching orbit and catching both stages, SpaceX will be able to significantly reduce turnaround times between flights, making space more accessible and affordable for both government agencies like NASA and commercial customers. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.